Nico and Vince.
Am I wrong? It's Dan Radio Style. Hope everybody out there is having themselves a great day. Oh, your goodness. We were doing a little bit of a show here on patience, trying to cover some of the bases to remind people. And this is just good to know because, again, I think for a lot of us, everyone, it's more of a, oh, I can't wait, I can't wait. And we're all, as I've kind of been breaking it into lately, in sort of almost three phases as far as the way I kind of see it is. There's three ways that people tend to come at me in their relation to where their SP is or their, you know, whatever they're trying to manifest, how close they are to it. And almost there, let's get the good one out of the way for those of you that are almost there and you're going to be their success stories for our people of tomorrow. It's important to make sure once you've had that date, once you've gone out with them, once you're starting to communicate a lot more when you weren't before, to keep things the way they were, kind of cool, kind of chill. Don't get over into it. Don't go too fast. Don't be thinking it's already where it should be. Give it time. It gets really tricky when you get to the very end because at that point you're very, very much interested and like you're almost there. Like you can taste it and smell it, right? You're like there. And you feel like you're there already, but they are not necessarily there yet, right? And if you go too fast, you freak them out and kind of push them away. And you don't want to do that. So again, when you're really close, be careful, a little patient. You're almost there. Don't worry. You got this. It's happening. Full show. But yeah, if you go too fast, you'll freak it out and that'll slow it down. It'll still happen most likely, unless you keep doing it or some sort of freaky thing. All right, but if you're almost there, you know what I mean? Like you're getting there. Right, you're on your way. It's important at this point because really it's just a distance. And generally the people that are at this place have their moments of doubt here and there, right? It happens for sure. Sometimes it'll bum you out for a little while, sometimes it won't, but whatever. But really there's still a little bit of that disbelief sometimes. And this is really the places, or even some of the self-love, like it just depends. There's still some things, right? You're still kind of dialing it in. And really once you get everything dialed in, you kick it up to that final, you're there. Like things start really solidifying. It really helps you know. But so when you're getting there, still a couple things you're just trying to work through, figure out. Maybe, you know, you keep doing a pattern. Just look for something that you keep doing and you're like, ah, okay, that's it. Because they'll reach out and then maybe I hit them hard. I've done this before for sure. You know, you'll hit them hard with a text and then a text again. And, you know, and it's like, oh, no. Just way too much, way too fast, right? So sometimes you got to find out where it is. What do I got to adjust? And once you do, you'll start to notice the success that you're manifesting. And it's great. Now, if you've got a way to go, it's okay. This is okay. We're all in just varying stages. It's all this is. No one's better or worse. And I think everyone in all the stages would definitely agree that there is no better or worse. Because even for the people that are like are closer, and they might be like, well, I'm closer. It's like, yeah, but what have you gone through to get there, right? Like you've been through some stuff. So again, once you're getting there, you've earned it. And for sure, but you've been through a lot of great stuff. So when you got a way to go, there's a lot of good, solid lessons. There's patterns for sure. There's anger. There's resentment. There's upset feelings. There's a lot of opportunities to forgive and move on and do these kinds of things. So there's a lot of really, really beautiful places that you can truly apply the concept of patience, right? Like you are beginning a process that's going to last a little while. Well, it's going to last the rest of your life, but it's going to take a little while to probably come through to fruition because of from where you're coming. There's a lot of challenges that sort of come along that way. And that's why it's an amazing thing. It's a life-changing thing. You will look back and you will be like, oh my God, I cannot believe I did that. I wish I would have done it 5 years earlier. It's an amazing thing. And everyone's got to find that within themselves. They find that in their own path. They find that along the way. But again, it's that level of patience. You're starting a journey. See it as such. See it going into this like I am investing in me. I don't care how long it takes. It's for me. And this is going to benefit me. And this person that I'm interested in is definitely a part of the me big picture. But I'm going to work on the littler me for the moment. Universe knows about the bigger me's desires. Let's work on the smaller me, right? Let's work on the little guy that's probably not been hugged enough lately. When you can do this, then you can kind of look at some of the obstacles that come to us. And again, all of us are coming at this from different levels. It reminds me, for anyone that's older, at least my age, older, and probably a hair younger. The old, like, aerobic videos, this is what this reminds me of. The old aerobic videos of, like, the, you know, late 70s and stuff like that. Like, they were, there was always levels. There was, like, the one person that was, like, the super ultra, like, person. Like, they were the aerobic master. And they'd be, like, doing all the major moves, like, up on the thing, you know, like, and then, like, the person that spends a lot more time on the couch was doing the, you know, the old man moves or the old person, whatever, you know. It was just funny because there always was these sort of levels. So again, what happens when we stumble? Just reminds me of the aerobics. I'm sorry. I had to go there. When we stumble, depending on where we're at, we all basically handle it the same way. It's just a variant in how long it takes, I think, is really one of the bigger differences. So the higher up this ladder, stage, steps, whatever, the faster you generally kick this habit when it happens. So what it is it's usually affirmations, self-love. Like, there's a number of things that at some point along this journey you find that work really well for you. So when things happen, you kick those out, like, bam, oh my God, I just caught myself in a little negative cycle, started saying, dude, you're good enough, you're great enough, all this stuff's working out, look how far you've come, look at all the things you've, like, you hear it, like, I've already got an imagined spiel that if I ever get into that moment and I just start saying positive things, and it's like, ah, good, okay, yeah, no, what, duh, you got, like, what, you're off your mark for a second there, it's cool, it happens. Sometimes if we let it go too long, it'll definitely start to drag us down, and we need some sort of way to turn that around. Now, someone had kind of asked me, and they used the word reassurance. And if it's a self-reassurance, like you're reassuring yourself, that to me is like doing affirmations. If it's an issue of having anyone outside of yourself do reassurance, that's something that you must stop immediately, because that is where you're essentially looking outside of yourself. You're looking to take energy from another individual to make you feel good right now. And that's not really how this is supposed to work. You're supposed to find that happiness within yourself. And when you find that, you are finally able to sort of turn it around. You are reassuring yourself that everything's okay through affirmations, maybe through meditations, maybe through some of the healing techniques. If there's anger, depending on how this is playing out, you can even do some of these forgiving techniques to yourselves. If there's something that happened in your past that's maybe caused some concerns, some weird behaviors, weird is not the best choice of word, some behaviors that are concerning, right? Like you're seeing patterns. Then sometimes you can try like the rubbing out, all these different things, right? There's different, the astral letters even work on ourselves. I've done it to myself. I've written at myself astral letters. So all these things, of course, certainly help. And I'll try to link some of the shows below as far as astral letters and some of these other different techniques where you can sort of forgive and forget and move on. But that's really what we've got to do. So when you're trying to work through all these things, all of us need our versions of patience. One thing that helps, I think, for many of us too, is staying busy. I think the people that tend to be in the higher stages, and they can comment, generally are busier doing things for themselves. Busy with life, happy, grooving, good things down here. Generally busy most of the time. Still having some fluctuation moments where they spend a lot of time focusing on other things outside of themselves. But generally speaking, you find as the more you focus on yourself, the more interesting things get as far as your specific person, oddly. Because you've already made the request. The universe is well aware of it. So asking over and over and over and over, nah, doesn't really help you any per se. Universe is like, I'm just waiting for you to decide for sure, because you keep going back and forth. You keep saying negative things, positive things, negative things, positive things. Come on, get your story straight. So staying busy along your path, another really, really good one. And I will say a lot of people that are trying to rush, this is another thing that I think is not a deal breaker, but certainly a brake stopper, like a brake pumper, right? Is when you're in a rush, when you're trying to go fast. Oh, you're just hitting the brakes. Oh, the second you're like, how can I do this faster? Oh, you're just hitting the brakes. You know, you're just jerking away all over the place because of that one. Stop. Stop with the trying to be in a hurry. There is no hurrying to repairing some of the damage that's gotten you into this position. If you're in that really, like, it has to happen quickly. Turn your game on, move through the steps, try to work through what's bothering you, try to forgive and forget. Like, if fast as you do that, faster you can get there. But again, if you're just trying to make something happen now, you're probably going to have a hard time making it happen. Of course, gratitude is always key, right? Being thankful for what you're trying to project. Be thankful for everything that happens to you daily. Being thankful for just the wonderful life that I currently have. Being thankful for everything. And you'll find in general, when you're constantly thankful for everything that happens to you, generally speaking, it starts to become mostly stuff that you would be thankful for. So just being thankful for anything that's good in your life and letting it be known to the universe or yourself or the person that's bringing it to you, because they're actually the one that, you know, the ripple effect somehow brought it back through them. So thank you. Like, they were the last part of the chain that brought that back under yourself, right? So it's beautiful. Thank you. That was really cool. Wow, that's awesome. It's so cool. So again, focus on where you're going, not where you are. I think that's really the last key point. Where you are going, where you would like to be. What is it that you wish to experience? I try to sometimes get people to think about this just in general when they're having a down moment, right? They're spiraling, they're negative, they're doubtful right now. They don't believe that the person, maybe they sent a text message and they didn't text back, right? So you're in that, he doesn't love me, right? That whole thing. What I still do, and it still works, and it, you start getting them to think about what they would like to experience. What is it that you would like to experience? I hear what you're saying that you're not happy about. I get you. You're not happy about that. Now, what do you want to experience? Like, what would be the, like, if you had a magic wand and could say, this is what I want it to be now, boom, bling, right? There'd probably be some sort of sparkle in there, some sort of effect. When you do that, it's pretty cool, and you get them talking about stuff that they actually enjoy, and then, gee whiz, all of a sudden, they actually start kind of feeling better, and you're like, huh, isn't that funny? So again, these are the ways we just try to get ourselves turned around when we're having those tough times. You got to remember that it's our thoughts that got us here. It's the things we allowed ourselves to think about. It's the wondering what they're doing, wondering why they're doing what they are doing, wondering if they feel a certain way. When we let our minds go down those paths, one, you're spending thought time definitely not focused on you, for sure. And you're thinking about things that are going to spin you down a rabbit hole. They will. And just pay attention. Watch yourself. Don't trust me. Do it a few times and just watch how it happens. You're like, yeah, that's totally what I'm doing. That's totally what I'm doing. I'm like, I wonder how he's doing. Huh. I wonder why he didn't text me. Like, I bet he had some free time somewhere, right? Wouldn't he have just somewhere had some? I can't believe it. Text message takes you all but what? Like 3 seconds to actually, right? How many of you have done this, right? How many of you just like started spinning yourself down that track? None of that's real. Not one single piece of any of that train of thought is real. It is completely made up in our heads, based off our fears, based off everything that we're subconscious and unconscious and like weird about. All comes out. Now, again, if you're smart and you're paying attention to all the crazy stuff you say, you actually start to see it's like a reflection of what it is that you're afraid of, what it is that you truly is your issue. So it's kind of cool from that standpoint because you'll just play it down this crazy path. So that's how we control it. But catch yourself. See it. People do it all the time and it cracks me up. And it's like, all right, what would you like to experience? Because that's the fix. Affirmations, however you want to get there. Affirmations work because it's just positive stuff, right? That's all you're doing. You're just saying things that are believable that are actually positive and cool rather than the other side of that. Hopefully this all makes a difference for you guys. It was huge in my world, and I love it to this day. It's the game breaker. It's the deal changer. I use it with all the stuff I have manifested already, for that matter. It's awesome stuff how it plays out. So hopefully that gets you guys going in the right direction. Going out with a song by Swedish House Mafia. I was on a kick today, and this song is pretty cool. Don't You Worry, Child. It's also featuring John Martin, apparently. I don't know. It's on Dan Radio Style. Upon a hill across the blue lake, that's where I had my first heartbreak. I still remember how it all changed. My father said, don't you worry, child. She has got a plan for you. Don't you worry.